Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to be showing you just a really quick way to mash up photos using Adobe Fresco. So a lot of us don't really have access to Photoshop, it's really expensive for most people, and on the iPad Adobe Fresco is free. So what we are going to do is we are going to create a reference image for an imaginary artwork by mashing up some photos. So to get started, I'm just going to select some images that I want to work with. When I click on the add an image, we start with the transform screen. So I can grab the corners and drag it to make it the size that I want. I can flip it horizontally or vertically to play with the direction and orientation of my image. I'll hit done when I'm finished, and then we can start playing around with altering the images as needed. So what we are going to focus on primarily are the Lasso and Transform tools. So the Lasso option has a few different selection methods. The first is where you just kind of like draw around what you want to cut out. The second is using kind of more of a paintbrush style. So we'll use both of them just to play with it. So we'll start with the traditional lasso. And what I'm going to do is I want to get rid of the sky here. So instead of like painstakingly erasing it, I can just draw around the area that I want to get rid of. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you can always clean it up later. And once you connect the circle or connect the line together, you end up with an enclosed shape. And from here, we'll notice down at the bottom, there's this menu here that offers to transform, erase, mask, deselect, and some extra options here for inverting or transforming the selection. But in order to do any of that, you need to change the layer type. So if I were to hit transform right now, it tells me I can't do it. So what I have to do is I have to select my layer here and then go down to convert to pixel layer. That's going to make it into a layer type that is compatible with all of these options. So my next step, I want to get rid of it. So instead of just taking out the eraser tool and erasing, I can just hit this erase button and poof, it's gone. So that's a really quick way of altering your images and getting rid of things. Now that I want to move on, I'm going to make sure to hit the deselect button to get rid of that little dotted line so that I can do other things. I think at this point I'm going to add a background behind this. So what's more fun than giant explosions? Now we'll note that this is in front of everything, so in order to get it into the background, I'm going to grab my layer and drag it behind everything. If I wanted to, I could still adjust this layer and move it around by clicking on the transform button right above the lasso button. So I can adjust the size, kind of play with placement, make it a little skinnier so it fits better in that space. And once I feel like it's in a good area, then I can hit done. So let's add in just a few more things just for funsies. We'll add a UFO. All right, I'm going to drag that or make it a little smaller. I'm going to drag it forward. It's aliens attacking the city. When we're in the transform option, we can rotate as well and adjust the size. From there, I can use my lasso tool like I have and select. I want to show you another option. So instead of just drawing right around it, we can use this paintbrush tool as well. And we can use the slider to adjust the size of the brush. So once I have that, I can just kind of like fill in my object. And let's say I get some stuff outside of the UFO that I don't want there. There is a button to select the inverse. So if we click this other box, we can go in and kind of cut back in and clean up our edges if we want to. We could get really precise and you know, zoom in to make sure we're getting everything that we need. And obviously, if this is just a reference, it does not have to be super precise. So I mostly just want to make sure that it is roughly what I need. And then I want to select the inverse now, because if I were to hit erase right now, it would erase the UFO, and that's not what I want. So I'm going to hit invert selection. That selects everything else. Now remember, we have to convert to a pixel layer before we can do anything. And then I can hit erase. Voila! Now I have a nice UFO causing mayhem. And lastly, I need to deselect to move on. So I think for my finishing touch in this image, I'm going to add a picture of my coworker. Because why not? Let's have her flipped around so she's pointing at the UFO. Wonderful. And we will select from here. I think I might draw around her again. So this could be really precise. It, in my quick sketch right now, it won't be, but I could clean it up if I so chose. And from here, I'm going to invert my selection and convert to pixel layer and erase. Oh, it's beautiful. Now I need to make sure I hit deselect. And I will transform so that she can sit in the picture a little bit better. Whoa! And we'll drag, kind of place her just so in the foreground. Maybe I want her a little bigger. Why not? Who needs proper scale? All right, so there we have a really quick and easy way to quote-unquote Photoshop your images to create new references. Thanks for watching, and keep creating.